How are you?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Looking good? Good. I go to the winning to warm up. Look.
Oh.
Like you say, first half I was really happy with how that went. To be fair, the girls scored a really good goal just before half time. The girls took that reasonably well when we spoke at half time. Second half we came out and we were confident when we came out. We thought we could push on in the second half and really make a game of it. But I think the second goal was a wee bit of a killer blow for us. The concentration went a little bit for that 5 minute period and we lost the third goal. And from that point on there was really no coming back for us. But second half there's a lot to take from that as well and a lot for us to build forward with over the next 2 weeks and looking forward to the Hibs game.
I think the second half was a lot better. The first half it seemed to be that we'd played three games, high intensity games over the last 9 days, and I think that kind of showed in the first half we were a wee bit slower and pace of the game was at a level that didn't suit us. But second half, once we got the pace of the game up that wee bit higher, then I felt that we started dictating the play far more and we looked far more threatening.
We knew that Glasgow City would have a lot of the ball, but it was about how we were going to react when we won the ball. And it's something we've been speaking about, not just for this game, but for previous games as well, is that we need to react better when we have the ball and keep better possession of it so we can put pressure on teams like City and the other teams in the top half of the league.
And before the game, we'd spoke that there might not be space in behind for the space would probably come around the edge of the box area. So that's why we had so many shots here. So you have to adapt to whatever the other opposition team brings you in terms of problems. So we just have to find where our solutions to the problems they give us. And we were lucky that Danny Scott's shot had found the bottom corner. Mm-hmm. So no, it wasn't by chance. It was certainly by design.
You were playing centre-back today. Do you usually play right-back for Scotland?
Yeah, I've been playing full-back a lot this season so far, just with the changes in the personnel in the squad. But unfortunately today we were missing quite a few players and people being on holiday and injuries and stuff as well. So unfortunately had to come back into centre-back, but it's not a problem for me. Like, I'll easily play anywhere. And I thought the girls done brilliantly for filling in different positions. And we put in a good shift today and unfortunately didn't come our way. So.
Certainly our forward play, our creativity, it's something that, again, over the break we've been working with and trying to improve the players, giving them more options. And certainly the creativity is something that we're trying really hard to work on and train and improve, because we feel as if defensively, an organisation, tactical shape, we've got that, we know what we're doing with that. It's just the goal scoring and creativity side of things we need to improve.
No worries. So you ran out 4-0 winners in the end. So how do you rate the performance of the team?
It's like, I think at the start in the programme the other day, I'd said that fasten your seatbelts because here we go. And it almost mirrors last season when it just kept coming again and again in terms of cup games and Champions Leagues and league games. And do you know what? I hope we've got as many games this season again, because it means we've been successful. Mm-hmm. And I'll just take it that as it comes.